and that's all that's really coming to mind.
Okay, thanks. We're still thinking about it down here, and we are getting good video down to the ground. Thanks.
And scope for DGBA, just on the status check, for 00-1643, the temperature's 8 degrees, everything is good.
Thanks for that detailed report, Pierce.
I left out the second.
Thanks, man.
This playback, as you saw, initiated pretty much at liftoff during the very few early seconds of launch. You saw the protective Tyvek covers. That was a unique design that was incorporated shortly after return to flight after the Columbia accident. These Tyvek covers were designed so that the air pockets that were designed into them actually would fill up with air and pull them off the vehicle very early during launch, so that they would not become a debris source that could do damage to the thermal protection system, and in particular the forward windows of the orbiter. So you see those Tyvek covers that protect the reaction control system thruster jets, the inlets for those jets, so that there's no moisture intrusion while the vehicle sits on the launch pad. They work very well for protecting those inlets from accumulating any moisture, but they also could become a debris source. And so the butcher paper that was used for years was replaced by these lightweight Tyvek covers with these unique air pocket designs that pull them off the vehicle before they would become a debris source. The other part of that view that you saw was the staging, which was essentially the booster separation motors that fire when the solid rocket boosters are jettisoned from the side of the external tank. You see the flash as the vehicle passed through the 2-minute, 4-second point where the SRBs were ejected or separated from the vehicle. Obviously, it's a fairly dark view because Atlantis launched northeast into a sunset fairly quickly during the climb to orbit. But this view was incorporated to provide imagery analysts here on the ground another view of the forward portion of the vehicle, but in particular the forward areas of the external tank, including the inner tank, which several flights back showed some sign of foam liberation around the stringers that, as they're noted, or as they're named, on the inner tank, which is the portion of the external tank between the liquid hydrogen tank and the liquid oxygen tank. Also, the view is incorporated.
The hub steps are bone dry.
Copy that. Understand the hub steps are bone dry. Thanks, Hawk.
The other part of that view that the teams on the ground wanted to see was the forward ice frost ramps, which essentially are small foam ramps that protect brackets along the forward side of the external tank up at the liquid oxygen.
Okay, sounds good. Thanks.
The crew is providing the ground with some real-time morning checks around the orbiter. You heard just a moment ago that the humidity separators are dry. The crew will check those every day. They're under the floorboards on the mid-deck. And the HUMSEPs, as they're referenced, the humidity separators, essentially do what an air conditioner would do in your home, and that is remove humidity from the atmosphere. And that humidity accumulates sometimes. We've had some issues with HUMSEPs leaking or generating some moisture, and the crew would sometimes have to towel that up. One of the routine morning checks after post-sleep is to look underneath the mid-deck floorboard, if you will, at those humidity separators to make sure that they are not accumulating any moisture. So that's a call you may hear just about every day after the crew wakes up and gets into the activities of its day. Continuing to head uphill with this playback, looking out the view. This is essentially the view that pilot Tony Antonelli had during Atlantis's climb to orbit. In the foreground, you're looking at the nose of Atlantis, and then off in the distance, you see the forward liquid oxygen portion of the external tank, and over on the right side, you see the cable tray that runs the length all the way up to the liquid top of the tank, the liquid oxygen tank, and the brackets that hold that in place are protected from any moisture accumulation when the tank is filled prior to launch by some foam over those brackets. These are known as ice frost ramps. They have, on a couple of occasions, liberated some foam from those brackets. The higher up, obviously, that those brackets are, then any foam that would liberate from those brackets could be a debris source that could do some damage to the thermal protection system. So this camera was installed, and this view was incorporated to provide the team with some additional views that it did not have before. So now this camera is a routine view that the crew will downlink when it gets an opportunity. Usually it's on the second day of the flight, since flight day one with launch is such a busy time. The crew will downlink this when it gets an opportunity. That's usually on flight day two. Atlantis's ride to orbit lasted 8.5 minutes. You see the orbiter as it begins to move into a daylight period. During every launch, the orbiter's guidance and navigation control system commands a roll to heads up, and that roll to heads up you see happening there with essentially the orbiter being in position, and you see there the external tank being jettisoned after main engine cutoff. A very unique view, the pilot point of view. Sometimes you'll hear the reference to PPOV with this camera mounted essentially in the forward window number 4, which is in front of pilot Tony Antonelli.